We're starting week two of our summer training program. I want to give a quick little bitty disclaimer. We have not started our Olympic lifts yet because I wait until week three. Those are highly intensive physically and highly coaching intensive. We want to install the other components of our training, the fundamental core lifts that we all have, bench squat, even deadlift. Our speed training is a priority. So the Olympics are coming and the athletes will adapt quickly. And we just don't want to take any false steps and have a overtraining situation come up by the 4th of July weekend when we're not done yet. So the Olympics are coming. Just stay tuned for that. Week two, day one, we're still going hard and heavy at all the running and lifting in the summer. And we're going to show you a few little changes that are going to come up. And this will happen week after week. So just pay attention to some of the details. We get our 0 to 10 day because it's Monday. And we're going to go with a regular warm up. And we use the half ladder today. And as we mentioned, this show, you can get in and out of that extended warm up and your athletes are ready to go. Now I want to show you that on our particular workout here, we're doing 8 hurdles. We call that the short course. We usually run 10 to 12 most of the time in our training. But today we're doing 8 hurdles because we want speed, speed, speed. We want those roadrunner feet, that fast turnover. We have a couple speed breaks in there to complement that. So you'll be running those 30-yard breaks. We'll come back 8 hurdles all the way through. When we get through with the hurdles, we're going to end up doing some speed training specifically. We have, again, the mini hurdles with a little bit different flavor to them. So we're going to go heavy hurdles on this 0 to 10 day because we want to start expanding the athlete's ability to take more steps. We have often counted to where we have 1,000-step workouts. And again, we're going to finish with 8 40s, 320 yards of speed work. So that way the workout stays compact and it addresses our 0 to 10 theme. Week two, day two, summer training. We're going to be looking at a 0 to 30 today. One of my favorite drills we're coming up here. Once you get warmed up, go through the half ladder and ready to go, we're going to do one thing we call a spatial illusion. So let me explain that in detail. You're going to lay out 10 hurdles, 4-foot spacing. Make all 10 hurdles or however many you have at 4 feet. That's critical. Now, what you'll do is just follow the workout and run through the hurdles. And here's where the spatial illusion comes in. If you learn how to lean slightly forward into the hurdles when you run, at 4 feet, they're going to be kind of a sluggish start because they're a little bit longer than you expect. Then they get normal in the middle. And if you can have 10 to 12 hurdles, the illusion is as you speed up, the spacing between the hurdles appears to shrink and it's still 4 feet. And that's where the athlete's footwork really becomes critical because you're not trying to slow down to make the step. You're trying to maintain the speed, touch the ground, get off and hit the next stride. So we call that a spatial illusion because you feel like your spacing is shrinking. Once you do the spatial illusion, do the speed break, come back. Now you just are faster on the hurdles. Week two, day three, a great first step training drill. This is exciting because it helps every athlete in the workout to get better with their first step. You're doing a workout we call 3 hops and run. And you're just going to land and take a 5-yard burst after you hop over 3 hurdles. Be sure you come over the 3rd hurdle. You've got to land on 2 feet to make it effective. So you're going to just follow the workout and you'll see how we have all those laid out in real short bites. Everything is explosive and good first step takeoff. Here we are, week two, day four. We've had a good hard week of change of direction and short sprints. We're going to go ahead and step on out there and do a series of 110s. Our 110s are 100 meters, so if you don't have a full field or if you're on a track, 100 meters, 110 yards, pick one and get after it. We're going to do 10 now. We're going to get that clock going. You're going to have a 17 to 19 second run with a 45. Everybody gets 45 second rest interval. So the 110s, bread and butter conditioning, that's day four of week two. For the full workout, go to kingsportstraining.com.